He seemed to have lost all his motivation since becoming a member of Raven's flock.
And it looks like a zombie, like his soul is not there, like he just waits for some kind of control from Raven or something.
Dutch off quickly here, kicking away at the Ultimo Dragon. In this match, we are live on Nitro, where Sting, Macho Man Randy Savage will collide later on tonight, as well as the Steiners against Kevin Nash and Buff Bagwell in a non-title tag bout. Up on top, here's this balancing maneuver by the Dragon. It always seems to throw opponents one step off, Mike.
Well, incredible agility by the Dragon with that headstand on the top, and then caught Kidman with the drop kick, and then a series of the most lethal kicks in wrestling.
Now that's combinations, one after the other, and Ultimo Dragon is good with combinations. Follows him up, stays on his man. Gotta keep his eyes off the flock, though.
Yeah, don't worry about Lodi, the sign guy down there at ringside. Stay focused on Kidman.
You know, we've always known that the Dragon has been one focused individual, and the Dragon, a good move by Kidman. Dragon's got him into the Dragon Sleeper. He's got him in the sleeper, and Randy Anderson.
That was Saturn on the opposite side of the ring with the interference.
As Lodi had Randy Anderson's attention. He had the match won right there, but once again, the numbers outnumber the opponent, and the opponent this time, Ultimo Dragon, could have won the match.
Well, they got him from the flank right there. Pee-wee Anderson, unfortunately, does not have eyes in the back of his head. Kidman took advantage of it.
Yeah, it's really a tough spot for referees. There's no question about that. Larry, you were one last year for one match. You know how tough it is, especially when you have more than one man around ringside. Here's a cover like you have when you have Raven's flock.
Well, it's extremely hard when you try to be fair, but you just can't see everything.
To the attack once again goes Kidman. Kidman is a fine athlete, make no mistake about that. A roll up, 1-2, and the Dragon almost beat him with a sunset flip off of the ropes. Kidman, the first man to get the blow in out of the break.
Really is a fine athlete, Tony, but really what happened to Kidman ever since he joined the flock, when he started off here in WCW, one of the most promising rookies, promising youngsters to come along in a long time. Master of the shooting star press. Very impressive top rope move. But now since he's joined the flock, career has gone downhill.
Now the young and useless guy just couldn't take the pressure. People don't realize how much pressure is on an up-and-coming guy who wants to be a star, you know, on Nitro. It's unbelievable, the pressure.
Well, fans, we've heard now that because of the package we've seen and the talk, the discussion we've made about the triple fine, here's a press by Kidman, but only a two count, that we are going to hear from Kevin Nash. He's going to come out and have something to say, I guess, in response maybe to this triple fine that we've talked about. We'll be seeing and hearing from him a little bit later on. Plus, Goldberg is here. Bill Goldberg will be with us. That's an event in itself. A cover, 1-2. And the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, will be with us as well tonight live here on WCW Monday Nitro.
I tell you, I like Goldberg, too. Here's a guy I think in... taking on a bigger Twister than Pecos Bill.
And there's a forearm shot by Kidman, but the Dragon fires back. Competitive matchup we're having for you here on WCW Monday Nitro. And Kidman has not backed down at all from the Dragon. He's had some help on the outside, but most of this has been on his own accord, Mike.
Well, Dragon had that one opportunity with the Dragon Sleeper applied before the numbers game of Raven's flock came back to help Kidman.
Knock some attitude back into you, running full bore right into the sole of a boot from the Ultimo Dragon. Dragon now, possible vertical snap, suplex, that's what it is.
Tell you, nice extension on that kick, a nice snap there. He's sitting low on it.
Single leg crag, but Kidman way too close to the rope.
Crab?
Yes, both legs the crab, single is a crag. Snapmare over. And look at this head scissor. Submission hold right here.
He's looking for the arms. He wants to pull those wrists forward. That hurts, brother.
Oh, good camera work that time, guys. And I mean, you've seen the pain on the face of Kidman. I don't think I've ever seen this move, Mike.
A small package submission type hold. Chance for Kidman now to reverse this if he hooks the arms.
Kidman has one shoulder down here, almost had two, and give Kidman a lot of credit for escaping that maneuver.
It was tough. If Kidman wasn't as small as he was, he wouldn't be able to squirm out of that. Anything that locks the neck backwards like that. Look at the balance.
And a standing switch by Kidman into a full Nelson. Oh, a back kick in the back of the head up on top. Setting down, 1-2.
Yeah, nothing over the shoulders.
Double leg takedown for a two count that time by Kidman.
Kidman on the rope.
Oh, springing off the ropes and planted him with the DDT. Gets two, kick out by Dragon.
To the attack again, Kidman. Into the neutral corner to the other side, Kidman.
One, two.
Almost pinned him, but that time the Dragon hooked the bottom rope. And Kidman getting a little frustrated now, fans. He told Randy Anderson, hey, that was three. But the match continues.
Well, Kidman's not thinking. He's going through a lot of moves, but not watching his ring positioning. It took too long there.
Took too long, and a simple kick by the Dragon ended that offensive attempt by Kidman. Dragon up on top. Could be the Frankensteiner. Fans start to erupt here. Down, and down he goes. Going to try the Dragon Sleeper once again.
Got it hooked on in the middle of the ring.
And nowhere for him to go. The Ultimo Dragon gets the win.